Okay, good morning all of you. Continuing in the series of lecture of pharynx, today we'll discuss about the structure of the pharynx. So coming to the points, which points that we have to discuss while describing the points on the wall of the pharynx or structure of the pharynx. So following are the layers which lies inside to outside, which are the structure forming the wall of the pharynx. First layer is obviously the mucosa or mucous membrane, which is the innermost layer. Just outside the mucosa, there will be second layer that is known as submucosa or pharyngobasilar fascia or pharyngeal aponeurosis. All three are the synonyms. Third layer, that is the main layer, which is known as muscular layer. So there are two types of the muscle, inner longitudinal muscle and outer circular or constrictor muscle, which is the main layer forming the wall of the pharynx or structure of the pharynx. And the outermost layer is known as buccopharyngeal fascia. So all these are the layers that we want to discuss from inside to outside. Okay, so in this diagram we'll discuss all the layers. So obviously the first layer, that is the innermost layer, which is known as mucosa or mucous membrane. So in the diagram, the mucosa or mucous membrane is marked by tortuous pink color lining, that is the mucosa or mucous membrane. So the mucosa is different in the different part of the pharynx. For example, in the nasopharynx, it is mainly ciliated columnar epithelium. In the oropharynx, it is non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. And in the same way, in the laryngopharynx, it is also non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. So that is the mucosa or mucous membrane. Just inside the mucosa, there will be mucous gland, okay, which is secreting mucus. And second layer, here in the diagram, we can see the green lining that suggests the pharyngobasilar fascia, which is in fact the thickening of the submucosa. Okay, this this thickness is the submucosa, and its thickening suggests this pharyngobasilar fascia. This pharyngobasilar fascia is more marked in the upper part of the pharynx. Okay, and it forms the second layer. Just outside the pharyngobasilar fascia, there will be the muscle layer, and the main muscle of the pharynx is the circular muscle or constrictor muscle. So there are three constrictor muscles that we will discuss later on, superior, middle and inferior constrictor muscle. And the outermost layer, which is known as buccopharyngeal fascia, that is the outermost layer, which is in fact covering the outermost muscle, that is the constrictor muscle. Okay, and sometimes it forms the epimysium of this muscle. So this is the buccopharyngeal fascia. Both buccopharyngeal fascia as well as pharyngobasilar fascia extend from the base of the skull up to the level of the pharyngoesophageal junction. Okay, so this is the overview of the structures which forms the pharyngeal wall. Okay, now in the detail we will go for this constrictor muscle as well as longitudinal muscle. Okay, so this is the diagram, this is the lateral view of the pharynx and trachea. So here mainly we will focus on the pharyngeal structure. So first we will discuss the circular muscle, circular or constrictor muscle. So here in the diagram, first we will understand the name, where they are located exactly, and then we will go for its origin, insertion, action and nerve supply. So first we locate the three constrictor muscle, above to downward. They are, uppermost is the superior constrictor muscle, below the superior constrictor, the middle one is the middle constrictor, and the lowermost is the inferior constrictor, which in fact having two parts. Upper one is the thyropharyngeus and the smaller lower one is known as cricopharyngeus muscle. Okay, so there are three constrictor muscle. Here in the diagram we can see these three constrictor muscle are actually arranged in the overlapping manner. As we can see somewhat posteriorly at the site of the insertion, they overlap each other. For example, the lower part of the superior constrictor muscle is overlapped by upper part of the middle constrictor muscle. Same way, the lower part of the middle constrictor muscle is overlapped by the upper part of the inferior constrictor muscle. Okay, so we can say this arrangement is like putting the three flower pot one on each other. Okay, So here we can see these three constrictor muscle, we can compare it with the three flower pot which are put one in another. Okay, so they are arranged in the overlapping manner. Okay, now going for the origin and insertion. Before we go for the origin and insertion of these three constrictor muscle, let's take some orientation about the bony landmarks. Okay, so above to downward, following bony landmarks we'll understand. This bony landmark is known as medial pterygoid plate. Medial pterygoid plate. Now, what is medial pterygoid plate? It is the projection from the base of the skull from the body of the sphenoid. There are two pterygoid plate, medial and lateral pterygoid plate. Okay, so this medial pterygoid plate will be related to the origin of the superior constrictor muscle. This is the upper jaw, this is the lower jaw. Okay, we can see the teeth as well. This is the body of the mandible. This is the zygomatic arch. This is the styloid process. This is the hyoid bone. This is the thyroid cartilage. This is the cricoid cartilage. And in the lower part, we can see various cartilaginous ring of the trachea. Okay. Now let's understand the each muscle one by one. So first muscle, that is the uppermost muscle, is known as superior constrictor muscle. Okay. Origin, insertion. Now the following are the points for the origin of the superior constrictor muscle from above to below. Okay, so the first point will be lower part of the posterior border of the medial pterygoid plate. This is the medial pterygoid plate. This is the projection from the base of the skull. Okay, this is the anterior border towards the root of the pterygoid process. This is the posterior border of the medial pterygoid plate. So the lower part of the posterior border of the medial pterygoid plate. Second point, pterygoid hamulus. This spiny projection is known as pterygoid hamulus. Third point, pterygomandibular rapet. This lining, this dark line, it suggests the pterygomandibular rapet. The name itself suggests it extends from the pterygoid process to the area of the mandible behind the third molar tooth. Pterygomandibular rapet. It is actually the fibrous thickening. Okay. Fourth point, the part of the inner surface of the body of the mandible behind the mylohyoid line, this much small part. Okay, and the lateral aspect of the tongue. These are the five points which gives origin to the superior constrictor muscle. Lower part of the posterior border of medial pterygoid plate, pterygoid hamulus, pterygomandibular raphe, posterior part of the mylohyoid line and side of the tongue. Okay, so these are the point for the origin of superior constrictor muscle. Now insertion. This is the posterior view of the pharynx along with its wall. So this is the superior constrictor muscle. We try to locate all the three constrictor: superior constrictor, middle constrictor, and the lowermost inferior constrictor muscle. Okay. After taking origin from all this point, it insert posteriorly. What is the direction of the fiber? Backward and medially and slightly upward. Okay. All they converge near the posterior median plane, and this is the key point for the insertion of all the three constrictor muscle, and it forms the pharyngeal raphe, median pharyngeal raphe. This green line, this dark green line suggests the pharyngeal raphe. Okay, so there will be interlacing of the superior constrictor muscle fibers in the posterior median plane, which is known as pharyngeal raphe. Now what is this pharyngeal raphe? It is actually the fibrous thickening formed by the interlacing of the all these three constrictor muscle, which extend from the base of the skull. Which part of the base of the skull? From the pharyngeal tubercle. What is pharyngeal tubercle? It is the bony tubercle which is located in the basal sphenoid bone to the extending up to the level of the thyroid cartilage. Okay, so this is the pharyngeal raphe. Okay, so in this way superior constrictor muscle insert into the pharyngeal raphe. Okay, upper fiber extend up to the level of the pharyngeal tubercle, and the lower fibers, that we cannot see, but it extend down inside the pharyngeal wall up to the level of the cricopharynx. Okay, so that is the superior constrictor muscle. Now the second muscle, that is the middle constrictor muscle. What is the origin? First we try to locate the hyoid bone. This is the hyoid bone, this is the greater cornu, and the smaller one is the lesser cornu. Okay, and this septum, that is known as stylohyoid ligament. What is styloid ligament? it extends from the tip of the styloid process to the laser cornu. Okay, styloid ligament. Now, which are the points for the origin of middle constrictor? 1, 2 and 3. Lower margin of the styloid ligament near the hyoid bone. Second point, laser cornu. Third point, upper border of the greater cornu. So, all these points gives origin to the middle constrictor muscle. Now, same to the superior constrictor. The direction of the fiber will be upward, backward and medially. Obviously, it has to insert into the pharyngeal raphe. Okay. Here, it is important to note that the upper fiber of the middle constrictor overlap the lower fiber of the superior constrictor. Same way, the lower fiber of the middle constrictor itself is overlapped by the upper fiber of the inferior constrictor muscle. Third muscle, that is the inferior constrictor muscle. It is the largest of these three group. It has got two parts. The upper larger part is known as thyropharyngeus and the lower smaller part is known as cricopharyngeus. Thyropharyngeus, name itself suggests, it has to originate from the thyroid structure, that is the thyroid cartilage. Okay, this is the thyroid cartilage. Okay, this is the anterior sharp border which is going to form the angle of the thyroid cartilage. This is the thyroid lamina, quadrangular in shape. This is the posterior border of the thyroid lamina. This is the superior cornu. This is the inferior cornu. Okay. This is the upper border and this is the lower border. Now, on the outer surface of the thyroid lamina, it has got oblique ridge. This is the oblique ridge. Okay. Which gives origin to the thyropharyngeus muscle. Okay. This oblique ridge is going to origin the thyropharyngeus muscle. What is the direction of the thyropharyngeus muscle? Same as of superior and middle constrictor, upward, backward and medially. So all these fiber converge into the median plane and form the pharyngeal raphe, median pharyngeal raphe. Okay. Above, it overlaps the lower margin of middle constrictor. Now, cricopharyngeus muscle. It is also smaller part of the inferior constrictor muscle, cricopharyngeus muscle. So, cricopharyngeus muscle mainly originates from the cricoid cartilage. So, which are the part of the cricoid cartilage? The anterior ring-like part is known as arch, and posterior part, broad part is known as lamina. Okay. So, the origin of the cricopharyngeus is from outer surface of the anterior arch of cricoid cartilage. Okay. Now, going for the particular point, in which part of the arch of the cricoid cartilage? In the area between cricopharynx and cricothyroid joint, Specifically from this area, this cricopharyngeus muscle will arise. Okay. Now, what is about the insertion? Cricopharyngeus, the insertion will be atypical. Okay. The fiber will not form the pharyngeal raphe. Instead of forming pharyngeal raphe, the fiber will go in the circular manner. It will cross the median plane and will merge with the fiber of the cricopharynx of the opposite side. So, in this manner, it will form the circular ring. Okay. That is why sometimes it is also known as cricopharyngeal sphincter. Cricopharynx also known as cricopharyngeal sphincter because its action is like a sphincter. Okay.